Electra.
How you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
Good. All right, wait, break. What's your real name?
My real name is Tara Patrick.
Now, I like that name. What is wrong with Tara Patrick?
Well, actually, the reason that I changed my name is because I had an album that the artist produced. And during that time, I think it was 92. During that time, there was another artist out by the name of Tara, so.
And was he Prince at that point?
Yes, he was.
Okay.
Yes.
The artist, formerly known as Prince, so he produced you.
Yes.
Okay, and there was an artist named Tara at that time?
Yeah, so we, you know, had to come up with a different name, and, you know, I fell in love with the name, and it's kind of catchy, and it's, here it is. Now I'm Carmen Electra.
No. Oh, I like that. So that's the move. That's how you got to do it. Electra.
Yeah.
I'm Byron Allen.
Byron Allen.
There you go.
Yeah, you gotta feel it.
Byron Allen. That didn't quite feel it. Byron Allen. See, people are breaking things around.
You could be like a martial arts kind of guy, you know.
There you go.
A hero. Superhero.
Okay. There you go. Where'd you grow up?
In Cincinnati, Ohio.
Cincinnati, Ohio.
Yeah.
Home of P&G.
Yes.
What did mom and dad do?
My mom was a singer. My dad plays guitar.
Okay.
And they were in a band together. And then they had me.
So you come from a musical family.
Absolutely.
So you really have music in yourself.
Yeah, yeah. I remember my dad's band would play in the basement. I was 5 years old and I would dance. And I always knew I'd be in this business somehow. Mm-hmm. Acting, I didn't think I'd do.
Really?
I've been dancing my whole life. So I thought I'd be on Broadway or maybe in a ballet company. So my life took a different turn, but I'm happy.
Now, how did acting come about for you?
I ended up getting the job on Singled Out for MTV, hosting that show. And then I was hired to do Baywatch, and from there I ended up on the show I'm doing now, Hyperion Bay on the WB. So I just feel really blessed. I've been really lucky, and the more I do it, the more I love it, so.
But tell us about Hyperion Bay.
Yes, Hyperion Bay. I play the role of Sarah Hicks. She's an intelligent, very powerful woman who goes into this company with the intentions of taking over. And so in order to do that, she has to manipulate, and she's very vampy. She's sort of the Amanda of Melrose Place. So it's a lot of fun because it's a challenge for me, and it's hard. It's hard work.
Are you a vixen?
I'm a vixen. Yes.
You like that, huh? Yeah. You like playing those
I
roles.
Do.
Yeah.
I love it.
Are you comfortable with the acting? You like it?
Yeah, I'm getting more and more comfortable in front of the camera. I mean, I think I've been really lucky to have, like, you know, Baywatch as sort of a playground, mm-hmm. place to learn, and, you know, I feel like it's getting better, and I'm loving it.
Okay, now what's the story? You have to give us the update so we can clear the record. Are you married? You're not married?
Yes, we're married.
All right.
Yeah.
Now, how's the big guy? What's his name again?
The big guy.
What's his name? Oh,
I kind of like that.
Well.
Big Daddy. You call
him. Oh, well, I don't ever want to call him Big Daddy. I just know he's a little taller than me. Just
yeah,
a 10.
Just a little bit.
What's his name again?
Dennis Rodman.
Ah, I've heard of him. I have heard of him.
Yeah.
And how's that going? How'd you two meet?
We met at a club called Billboard Live in L.A.
Okay, and what did he say to you?
His friend grabbed me by the arm, pulled me over to the bar. I look up, and there's Dennis Rodman standing in front of me. We hung out for the rest of the night. My girlfriend slipped and broke her arm. So they took my car to rush her to the hospital, and I'm left at Billboard Live with Dennis Rodman and his entourage. Dennis wouldn't take me to the hospital to get my car. He wanted to go to Fatburger and get some food. So I end up at Fatburger. Finally, I walked away from the whole scene, caught a cab, went to the hospital, and then like 2 days later, he tracked down my number and called me. And we started hanging out, and the rest is history.
So your first date was at Fatburger?
Yes.
Okay, while your girlfriend was at the hospital with
yes.
a broken arm?
Yes.
And he wouldn't take you?
No. He was hungry.
He was hungry. I love that. Listen, baby, I know your girlfriend broke arm, but I need something to eat.
Yes.
But I like you. And if you don't give me your phone number, I'll track it down anyway. I mean, so yeah. How did you know he was the one for you?
You know, everyone knows that kind of wild, crazy side of Dennis. And it's there, believe me. But he's actually very passionate and very down to earth. And that's the person I fell in love with.
And it can't be easy being married to such a, you know, a unique, controversial person
no,
in the limelight.
Hard.
It is hard.
It's very hard.
Now, help me with the confusion. Why was there confusion? You were married, you weren't married, annulled, then you were married, and then annulled. What's the story?
Okay. Mm-hmm. We went to Vegas, and he asked me to marry him. He wasn't drunk. I didn't force him to marry me. I didn't beat him up or whatever. I mean, there's so many rumors going around. His manager, for some reason, just wasn't happy about it and decided to release a false statement without even talking to Dennis to find out the situation. And that's what caused all the drama, but he fired his manager, and I think that was the first step in our relationship, so.
And that was enough to prove to you he was serious about you?
Yeah.
Yeah. All right, so any kids in the future?
Oh, not anytime soon. I have to focus on my career right now.
On your career?
Yeah.
All right, and when you're not working, what do you two like to do?
He's usually out. He likes to go out. He likes to party. I like that every now and then, but not all the time. So we try and balance out our time together and make things work.
Now, wait a second. If he goes out and parties and you're at home alone, what are you doing?
You know, I'm usually working.
You know what? Tell your husband.
I get up at 4 a.m. Uh-huh. And he goes to bed at 4 a.m., so.
This is a perfect marriage.
Then
you don't
here.
See each other.
Yeah.
Tell your husband to come home.
We might actually last that way.
Baby, you wake up at 4, I get home at 4, I'll see you when I get home.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
Tell your husband to come home.
Dennis, get your butt home. No, it's all good.
It's all good?
He comes home to me, so.
All right, anything you want to say to your fans out there?
Thank you for all your support. It's been great. I love you guys.
All right.
Peace out.